Hey there, it's Lynda Cromar. I'm coming to you from Colorado in my home office. And I just rearranged my room. I've got a little bit cleaner looking room. Anyway, don't be so quickly offended by all the words and things being said. And actually find out what the issues are. Find out the truth. You know, this is going to be the year that's going to decide, actually, whether or not we keep our country intact or whether it becomes the part, just one piece, of a global world government. Now, I know you probably think that I'm just offering you a whole bunch of conspiracy theories, but no, I have been studying it and it is the truth. Unfortunately, the Democratic Party, as we once knew it, has gone away and has been taken over by people that intend to completely dismantle our country. You can go and find plenty of evidence of this. And even if you don't want to believe that, you've got only two choices when it comes to deciding who is going to be our presidential candidate that is going to win. Two choices. You've got Hillary Clinton or you've got Donald Trump. The 2 or 3% that goes to the others will not create a president in the third party. So what typically usually happens is the votes that tend to go to those parties could generally have been a Republican vote. So that means that you are just supporting Hillary. Now, what are you supporting if you support Hillary? Let's go through that. You support open borders. You support unlimited amount of immigration that is hurting us in every way possible. Let's just review a few of them. They take away the low-income jobs from other people. Generally speaking, it's the minorities. Now, it happens to all of us, though, and generally, it also drives down the productivity of all Americans, making it possible for us to be more dependent than ever before. Number two, with Hillary, you are supporting a gigantic hike in taxes. She claims it's only going to be for the rich, but let's face it, how many of those are there? The problem with that kind of an attitude is you run out of other people's money, and then there is nobody to tax at all. And what happens to a state where the majority of the people are on some kind of assistance? They eventually cannot get that assistance. That means that our country completely fails. Everything completely collapses. So you got to decide, is that what you want? That's only two of the major issues. Now let's look at the other side of that. Donald Trump wants to build a wall. He wants to limit the amount of new immigration. He wants to remove all of the very dangerous elements immediately that are in our country that break our laws, that cause harm. He also wants to remove those who are illegal yet living on American assistance, food stamps, and our other kinds of American assistance. How far can that assistance go when we know there are many Americans that don't receive any help? They are above the cap because they maybe have a part-time job, but they can't make it. Or there are the veterans, many of which are not getting any assistance at all. And she just says everything's just perfectly fine. And she also wants to bring in more and more and more of the Syrian refugees or others, which we have no idea where they are, who they are, and what they really intend. And the one major issue that nobody wants to talk about but Trump is that they have philosophies and way of living that's actually anti-American. If you like the idea of a government that's going to start saying Sharia law is okay, then go ahead and let Hillary become our president. And also one other thing you may not know, because the news media won't cover it, is that she had a foundation, still does, called the Clinton Foundation, and also the Global Initiative, which much is not spoken of, both of which receive large amounts of money from all of those countries that support Sharia law, which means that you get to wear a burqa. If you're a woman, you get to have a man tell you what to do, and you don't get to do any of the things that you are enjoying right now, like driving, like having a job, like making your own money and having your own business. All of that will go away if you decide that Hillary is going to be our president. And let's be sure we understand, those of you that don't want to vote this year because you don't like either candidate, you're still voting for Hillary. Because those of you that decided that you don't want to be part of this system, while it's still our American system, you're voting for Hillary. So, you know, get over this thing about believing that he has to be the perfect candidate. He's got some good ideas. He's not perfect. Who is? I mean, if you look back at all the presidents we've ever had, there's always flaws. Not a single one of them is absolutely perfect. Even Reagan, even Kennedy, you know, probably even Lincoln, if you want to get honest. So let's get real here. We're talking about human beings. Presidents are human beings. They're not Jesus Christ. And I know you're going to probably holler at me for saying that, but he's not. He's not going to be. But he does stand for some of the things we care about. Like intact, keeping all of our amendments intact, like freedom of speech, freedom of religion, and freedom to bear arms. Now, those are only a few of them, but I can guarantee you that if Hillary gets in, she will put the most liberal possible justices in our Supreme Court. Which means that you don't get to say anything anymore. Complete censorship of all of our amendments. And it's already happening in our internet. Have you noticed that some words actually make you lose your account? Or some words actually make you lose that post you put up? Have you noticed that it doesn't let you do certain searches already? That is censorship. And that is just more of what we're going to see. If you don't realize right now that this is not about, oh, he's not my favorite guy, okay, then you don't care what happens to America. Because really, when we get down to it, this is a very, very serious vote this year. More serious than we've ever had before. It's time to get off the fence. Go listen to a real talk, like the last one he just did about immigration is a good one to watch. Also, did you notice that he went to Mexico? A lot of people making a big stink about that, but he looked very much like the president I want to see. You know what? He's a businessman. He's a billionaire. And he did it honestly. People are jealous of that. And you know another thing you can definitely check out that really impressed me? He's got 4 adult children, all of which who are smart, who are articulate, who are successful. They know their mind. They speak their mind, and they're not blind followers. I like that. You know what? When we teach our children to be grown-up adults that know how to stand on their own 2 feet, we can take credit for that, because it's a whole big process to be a good parent. And maybe you'll say, oh, it was the mothers. No, it wasn't just the mothers. They'll all tell you that they walked construction sites together with their father, that they learned how to negotiate with their father. And do you really think he would turn his whole company he worked so hard for over to kids that weren't responsible, not in your life. So think about those things before you make your decision, because the time is getting very, very short. It's very, very important that you actually vote. And yes, you may not like everything Donald Trump says, and that's okay. But he's going to be the people's president. And the news media doesn't like that. And that is a good reason right there to believe that he's the right man for the job. Is he perfect? Not by a long shot. But I call him my Patton. Do you know who General Patton is? He was one of the major generals in the World War II conflict. He is actually a relative in my ancestry. And even though he's no longer alive today, he believes in being honest. He believed in being honest and being straightforward and maybe blunt at times. And you know what? I like that. I'm tired of us pussyfooting around when we talk. I'm tired of us saying that we don't get to say certain words. I'm tired of all of that. I'm ready for us to get back to a more honest America, aren't you? So give that some thought. Instead of being in such a silly position of letting everybody else make your decisions for you, because being able to vote is a privilege, not a right, and it can be taken away. So let's do something about that. I hope you listened. I hope you share this. And I hope you really give it some good thought. I will be talking to you more about it, I'm quite sure. Bye for now.